Well, hey there, YouTube. Madam Roy back again. You may notice that the camcorder's sideways. I've never actually used this Sony DCR TRV-280 that way, but really pretty much the only way I could get this item all in focus at one time. This is going to be the topic of our discussion today, and this is something I've had for quite a while. Some of you guys may already be able to tell what it is without me actually opening it up, but we'll go ahead and do that right now. Whoop. This is something I picked up at the thrift store probably 2 or 3 years ago. This was before I really started making a lot of YouTube videos, and I had totally forgot about it. It was in that closet over there, shoved in a corner. And I decided to take it out today because I think this would make an interesting video. A lot of you guys that seem to like my vintage electronic videos will probably get a kick out of this. This is a stereo system, but a very special one. As you can see, it is a tower model. On the sides here, we have the speaker grates. Now, the speakers aren't all through this, and I'm hoping maybe that the infrared light will kind of show you guys what I mean here. I'm going to turn it to night shot. You can see it a little bit. There is a tweeter up here, right there. There is no mid-range, and then there's just a woofer on the bottom. Now, I have seen some models of this to where there was a mid-range speaker, but even though there's an indent, there's nothing there. You can't see a shiny piece like you can up in here. You can kind of see right there, that's where the tweeter is. This is a Magnavox brand, produced between 1970 and 1972. I looked up the production dates a few years ago. It is a little worse for wear. This was not from me. This was like it when I got it. It looks like maybe somebody had scraped it against a wall or something at one time. And then, of course, on the other side here, you have the exact same thing. It's the same speaker grill. So it is a stereo system. On top, another neat thing is, if you look here, this is actually leather. It's a very thin leather on top of the wood veneer, but it's still in this part's in excellent shape. What I think this was designed for is, say you wanted to add more components to it, you could probably put a small, maybe reel-to-reel or a cassette player on top of this. But again, it's in very good shape. We'll go around to the back real quick. You really don't see anything in the back. This is just all the wood veneer. Again, I think somebody had did a little damage there against the wall. And then we come down here to where you have some extra components and things. As you can see right there, we have the phono play-in. So this is actually made to where you can put in a phonograph. I don't know if you can actually plug anything else in here because I think there is a preamp. So I may have been mistaken there. You might only be able to put the extra component might just be able to be a phonograph on this. You can turn the internal speaker on and off, which is really cool here. That's if you want to hook something up to here. You could have actually external speakers hooked up to this. Of course, you have your FM and AM antenna. The AM antenna is a loop antenna, I believe, that's built into the cabinet. There is an internal FM antenna, but here you can also put an external one in if you want. And I'm not exactly sure what this switch does. This might also have something to do with turning off the speakers. Maybe this one does the left speaker and that one does the right speaker, but I'm not exactly sure. And over here you have some weird external power source. I never could figure out exactly what that was used for. It's not the power plug because you can see the plug goes underneath the system here, and I have it plugged into my closet right now. That pretty much completes what's on the outside of this, so without further ado, let's go ahead and open this bad boy up. It's a little stiff. Now, as you can see, internally, this is the actual receiver part. It's funny, it's actually horizontal in here, like a lot of the old ones were back then. The first dial up here, you can see you have various number of settings. You have off, you have stereo phonograph. That's the phono input right there. You have FMC, which stands for automatic fine control. Sometimes they call them AFT, automatic fine tuning. And that's also, I believe, the stereo mode. You have regular FM mono mode. You have AM mode and tape mode here, which actually is an 8-track tape, which is built right into the bottom of that. We'll discuss that further in a couple of minutes here. You have your balance control, bass, treble, loudness, and finally tuning. None of there, you can see it's made by the Magnavox Corporation. It is solid state, which means there's no tubes. It's all transistors. And, you know, when I looked at the date, I didn't originally believe this was from the early to, like, 70 to 72. But looking at that logo, that's what they looked like right around that time. So I think the Google search I did I looked at a few forms. I think they were right on the money. I'm thinking this one came out right around 71. And as you can see here, it's got a really cool Magnavox badge with a shield, which is actually something I've never seen before. Let me know if you know more about this particular logo, because I've owned a lot of Magnavox equipment back from this time, and I don't remember ever seeing that on any of them. You can see the tuner dial. It is a lit dial, though I think most of the lights have actually gone out. Last time I used it, I saw like a light up here. There's usually three or four lights that are in there, and of course this is before LED, so these are just regular bulbs. And I think most of them have actually gone out. But oddly enough, the light for the FM stereo still works. Down here, again, we have the 8-track player, and what I thought was really cool about this is you get a storage space for all your 8-tracks. I mean, granted, I have more 8-tracks than this, but back in the day, you could store, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, say 10 or 11 8-tracks there. And I'm going to do a demonstration of this, praying that the YouTube copyright police don't get me. I'm going to try the radio first, and then we'll go ahead and give the 8-track player a whirl. It's actually on right now. I do have a problem with this knob up here. I've tried cleaning the contacts, but I think it's just worn. If you don't, you have to kind of fiddle around with it, or it'll just play out of the left channel for some reason. I think the potentiometer is actually worn out, because I've been in here before and cleaned all the contacts out and didn't seem to do much good. So let's go ahead and give this a demonstration. It is on right now. And let's see if I can get anything to come out here. You can see I don't have the FM antenna. And there you go, you can see that FM stereo light came on. It's not a bad sounding system at all for its age. I think that's enough. Now I'm going to go ahead and try a tape. Now again, I haven't used this in about 2 years, so I'm not even sure this works. It did work the last time I tried it, so this is going to be live and on camera, folks. Gonna turn this to tape. Turn the loudness or volume up maybe about a quarter or so. And let's see what 8-track should we try here. Elton John, they'll probably get me for that one. Best of Mahalia Jackson. I think we might be safe with this one. These are some old hymns. So let's go ahead and give this a try, see if it still works.
I believe for every drop of rain that falls.
Sounds like it does. So you can hear if I turn the balance over, right now it's only playing out of the left channel. So I'll turn the balance to the right, and if I wiggle this switch up here.
The door.
Gotta do it just right.
Oh, the strength.
Yeah, this is really finicky. Yeah, see, I'm only getting it either to play out of the right or the left channel right now. See, if I do that, then it stops playing out the left, so this switch definitely needs to be repaired. But it does work. It sounds like it might need a little bit of lubing. I did lube this up when I first got it, but you can hear it's a little slow at times. Try and get this. Well, I finally got it with a little bit of playing around with this knob. I got it to come out of both speakers, that side and then that side. Well, that was a review of my Magnavox tower style stereo system with AM/FM radio and 8-track player. Hope you guys enjoyed this. If you like these old radio reviews, please let me know, because I got a lot more that I can do. I just need to take them out of the closet. Please remember to like and subscribe. And as always, have a blessed day, everybody.